I wanted to tell you about a new study that I recently read about that I thought you might find interesting. And it was a study done on knee pain and hip strength. And I think it's particularly relevant for our community because it questions some common biases that are held by many people in the fitness, movement, and yoga worlds. So here's the deal. The study was done on knee pain and hip strengthening exercises to target knee pain. It was specifically looking at patellofemoral pain, which is pain in the front of the knee, and the patella is our kneecap, so that's where it gets its name. So research has historically told us that strengthening the glutes can be really good for improving knee pain. So that would be strengthening the posterior and lateral hip, or the posterolateral hip strength exercises. Those tend to be what are traditionally prescribed for knee pain. And you may be kind of familiar with just like the buzzword that glutes has become. And everybody just seems to focus on the glutes and how important they are to strengthen for pain and function and all this stuff. And of course, strengthening the glutes is important, but is that like this one magical area that's important above all other areas? I don't know. So the researchers in this study, they decided, because so much has been done on posterolateral hip strength and knee pain, but I don't think anything had been done on anteromedial hip strengthening and knee pain. And that's like, you never hear of that being recommended for knee pain. It's always the glutes, right? It's never the front and the inside. It's always the lateral and the backside. So this study took a group of women, 52 women, and divided them in half. And half of them, and they all had patellofemoral knee pain. Half of them were prescribed posterolateral hip strength work. Half of them were prescribed anteromedial hip strength work. And just so that we have an idea of like what that looked like, I'm going to show you what's the examples of those exercises, and then I'll tell you what they found. But the people that did the more what we tend to think of when people have knee pain and we think they need to strengthen the back and the side of their hips. So they did, half of the people did clamshells. So this is strengthening the lateral and the posterior hip or the glutes. And they also did, they did more, I think they did maybe three exercises. These are just two of the three, but they also did straight leg hip abductions. So all of this kind of targeting the outer side and the back. And then the other group, who did the kind of less conventional hip strengthening, the front and the inside, they did, so they did these like adductor raises, like kind of Jane Fonda style. So this is targeting the adductors that cross the medial hip. They did an adductor squeeze where they like squeezed into center, and then that was like firing up the front and the inside. And they, again, I think they did three, and I'm just showing two of the exercises just so that we have like some examples. So anyway, the study looked at how both of those two differing types of hip strength exercises, how they, what kind of effect they had on the knee pain. And it found that both styles of exercise improved knee pain equally. They were both equally effective. So even though we've always had this bias that glutes are like the important thing that people need to strengthen, and I know for more than just knee pain, this is, you know, studies have to be specific and look at just one thing, but I find that glutes tend to just get like, people default to them as needing to be strong for everything, for back pain and knee pain and just pain and dysfunction in the body in general. And while of course it is important to strengthen the back and the side of the hip, it also can be equally helpful to strengthen the front and the inside. Like maybe we just might want to think about well-rounded hip strength. So at least this study seemed to suggest that for patellofemoral knee pain, it didn't really matter which side of the hip you targeted for strength in order to improve the knee pain. Like all of it seemed to help. So to me, that's just a suggestion that kind of well-rounded strength can be helpful.